Yes, welcome again for this tutorial. We are still on human resource, and this last time we checked, we discussed on how you can do a payroll processing on this human resource, and we saw how easy it was and how user friendly the system interacts with you. So just how the system will does the interaction with you so it's not a system that if you're not you do not have any idea of what to do, you will fail to know what you're supposed to do. So the system itself will guide you on what you're supposed to be doing. It will show you exactly what you need to do. So that is how you do the human the payroll processing. So now we can check on these contracts. So you can see this is where you can add contracts, you can renew contracts, and you can also do what we call activate or maybe set people to permanent basis. So if you want people to go through permanent or check on contracts, you are able to do it here. What you only do is that you do a renewal. You can either renew via each and every staff. Like for example, if this is the staff, definitely you select the staff here, and then this is the staff. Okay, we just use them. So this is the staff, and you want to actually, you know, make him permanent, include, or if maybe you want to show contracts of type, you can actually select the kind of contracts that he has, or you can see and then maybe select all the contracts here, or maybe you can check if the contracts are expired. So this is where you can do that. So you can either follow staff wise, or maybe you can follow branch wise, or depending on different the branches or offices that they are working, or warehouses that they are working on. So you can be able, so the moment you select a warehouse here, then the staffs will appear here. So how do you renew? You simply come here and renew staff's contract. So if this is the staff, first of all you select their names, or you can even select a staff here like him, and then I say I renew the contract. Like now you can see that staff there, and then you can check his existing contract permanent. Yes, you can check he's active. So with him he's on a permanent basis, so there is nothing here to renew. But if you want to see those ones that are on contract basis, like for example, let's say we just come here, so there are those, like you see the staff here, and then if he's on a contract basis, you select the contract, and then here you are able to renew his contract. If his contract expired, then you are able to extend the contract up to what day and or wherever which date. So it shows you the start date and then the end date, so you can constantly extend this contract, or you can reduce the contract. So this is how you do a renewal of each and every staff. But there is a situation whereby you will want to there are more than one staff members that will need but this one is telling me please select the entries you wish to bulk renew. So I don't have the entries here. That is the problem. So let me see. So here, if I select the entries, I'll have to select entries here. But unfortunately, I don't have the names of people that I'm supposed to bulk renew. Let me see if I can do this. This one is not on contract basis or probation basis, is on permanent basis. So if you want to do a bulk renewal, what you only do, you click the bulk renewal. Okay, so this one is for another staff, for this one. So if you want to do a bulk renewal, right now it is not opening, but if the staff I'm selecting that he's on contract basis, then it will give you a window whereby you are able to select each and every staff that you want to renew their contracts. You can as well view, you can delete, and you can print. Then there is this paperclip mechanism, which is a mechanism that turns physical documents into a digital document. You simply just scan a physical document and then you upload it into the system via this mechanism called the paperclip. So this is the window where you can renew contracts, you can terminate contracts, or you can select somebody into a permanent, change them into a permanent basis, okay, or you can put them in contract basis wherever you want to do. So this is the window that you can do that. The other thing here is that benefits. So we have benefits here mostly for different companies. Different companies offer different benefits for their employees, especially certain employees who maybe considered senior. Okay, you find an employee is given a housing, or maybe he's been given electricity, or the company pays for them water, or maybe furniture, the house is furnished, or even telephone bill, or even they have workers like cooks, groundsmen and all that, or even a vehicle. These are some of the benefits that the employee or an employee who has come to the company and is given those benefits, if they have these benefits, then they have to be included so that the system can be able to calculate, okay, their salaries and all that stuff. So this is where you add all those types of benefits. If it is work, if it is workers in terms of groundsmen, you can just simply do add, and then you search for that worker. Let's say if I'm searching for Christopher, so this is the worker that is working for this guy in his house. So you are able to know this, each worker has been assigned to this employer. This employee could be maybe the CEO of the company, he could be the senior manager of the company, maybe an expatriate, that he has to be given these benefits. So these are the benefits that you need to add for them, so that when you do calculation, the calculations can be real. And then we have here leaves. So this is where you can view the leaves of a staff. Let's say if you've put this staff here. So this is the staff you put here, you can view his leave. If you want to view, this is what we call the leave manager. So if you're not sure of a staff as to when did he go for leave, or when his leave is supposed to be, so this is the leave sheet. You are able to view like when the leave period will be, when will the leave be, and all that stuff. So that is when you leave that, and then from there you are able to set the leaves. This is where you do the setting of the leave. You can say maybe 21 days, so from this date to that date, so you can save, and then you save it. So once you've set the leave, then you come here and do the posting of that leave. So this is where you can do the posting of the leave. So there is an annual leave, and then there is maternity leave. Now because he is a man, then the maternity leave is not active, but if he was a lady, then this one will be active here. Okay, and then we have the leave types. There is a days, and then there is encashed leave. There are those who will say, I don't want to go for my leave, but I just encash me so that I continue with work. So they are encashed. Okay, and then of course we have the sick leave, and then we have the paternity, it's called what? The paternal leave. Paternal leave, whereby the fathers will go for leave because their wives are pregnant or whatever. So, sorry, not the wife are pregnant. Maybe the wife have actually put to bed. So the father is given some days to be at home and all that. So those ones are all calculated here. All those are calculated here. But the main ones that we've indicated is the annual leave, the maternity leave. Then their leave type, they are those which are days, and those are which are encashed. And all of them, as per the government, supposed to be 21 day leave. So it's calculated here. And if those leaves, you want to include even the taxable allowances, you can include those taxable allowances here. You simply just click that, and then you select the type of allowance that these employees are receiving there. But if there is none, you just remove that tick there. Okay, then if you want to post the leave, you put the tick there, and then you say okay, and then the leave will be posted. So that is how you do the posting of the leave. You can as well delete the leave or terminate it. That is if you have the rights. Of course, HRs will have the rights, and this is where they can delete those leaves if they want to. Okay, and then we have a leave chart here. So this is the leave chart. So the leave chart here, it shows you, like you can see the yellow band, it says expected leave. So this one here, like this guy is expected to go for leave from this date. Okay, he's expected to go for leave. And then the purple one shows the previous leave days. So if the previous leave days will indicate somehow like purple, and then previous leave and cached, these are in cached leaves. Also, they will indicate, just like the way you are seeing here, that it has been indicated. So this is a chart just to guide the HR on who is supposed to go for leave, on who is not supposed to go for leave, who has actually previously gone for leave, so that you don't take the company by surprise, so that the HR is able to prepare himself, knowing that this is what is expected and this is what is done. And then we have also notices here. Okay, notices, this way you can give your staff a notice. Just give them a notice of 30 days, or tell them maybe from this date your services will no longer be needed in the company. So this is where you put the notice. So the notice itself is inbuilt. Yours is just to put the name here, just name of this staff. You say that, and then you save. So once you save, the staff will receive a notice. Okay, say that. So you see the notice here issued by who? Maybe the HR manager. So he's going to receive a notice which is inbuilt in his mail, telling him that his services will no longer be needed from whichever date. And every time he comes to clock in, okay, through the service, you will also be notified. And then we have the termination part of it. So this is now the end of it all. So the termination, this is where you sack people, or maybe somebody has terminated his contract. Now, before you terminate somebody, there are some things you need to consider. Type of termination, if it is a dismissal, okay? It is a dismissal, it is a 30 days notice, or is that 30 days notice by staff, or arbitrary termination by employer, or arbitrary resignation by the staff. So these are the types of terminations that you can check. And then termination date, you put the date there, and then you put the comments. You can put the kind of comments you want to put. So once you've put the type of comments, you do what? You terminate. You just click here, terminate. But before you do that, there are things you need to check. First of all, one is that the account, of the current account of the employee, and then his attendance. Okay, for how long has he attended before you do the termination? And then also his leave. You can check the types of leaves that he has, so that before you do a termination, you may organize that for his compensation. Okay. And then they are also guaranteed, those are guarantors. You can check also on guarantors, and then the guarantee account. You can also check the amount of money that he has in his guarantee, and then the type of notice. So once all this is settled well, then that is when now you can come here and click the button. Okay, you can select here which type. If it is a dismissal, you just say the summary dismissal from this date, you put comments why, and then you terminate. So all this report will still remain in the system, because you never know, 10 years, 20 years down the line, this guy may come back to the company and ask for a job. And maybe the HR that did the termination will no longer be there. But now the system will have kept the records of this guy to show the reason as to why he was terminated. Maybe because of theft, dishonesty. So you may not know, okay? So that is, it's good to keep the history of people. So that's why this history of termination will always be in the system. And then we have miscellaneous here. This is where you put employment categories and operations categories. Okay, this is where you set them as per the government operations. They know which categories are paid what, up to how much. So this is according, it is in accordance to the government policy. So you don't just put your own things here. And then we have also operations category. Yeah, this one now you can put as per the company, because different companies, they have different operations category. So those ones you can indicate them there. And then we have statutories. Okay, statutory, the NSSF, and then the NHIF. So here you can pull the NHIF, the payee. So there you can indicate there. And then there's the lower and the upper deductions. And then there's also the as per deductions in terms of the lower and upper. So there you can do. So tomorrow, if there will be a change of the law, you don't have to worry about this. What can you do with this system? You simply come here, because you have the rights, you select, and then you put the figures the way the government will have changed. If tomorrow the government says deductions will be now 10,000, you indicate here 10,000. How do you do that? You simply edit here, okay, from the mutual ones. So you put there the lower, what the government is saying, and the upper, what the government is saying, and then deduction value, what the government will be saying, then you say okay. And then from there, you are good to go. Likewise, also with the NHIF, the same way you can do. The government changes tomorrow, you can come here and put the lower case and the upper case, and then put the deduction value, and then say okay, then you're good, you're also good to go. including even the payee, okay? It's the same way. You can put the lowercase, uppercase, and then you say what? And then you save, and then you're good to go. So you don't have to change the operation. The system is actually can adjust, and it is flexible in each and every conditions. Okay? So the allowances here also you can set. Remember, when what you are speaking about those allowances, you can also indicate the allowances that the company is giving its employees. Different company with different allowances, they can put either taxable allowances, and also there are some other non-taxable allowances. So in case of a taxable allowances, you click here. Non-taxables, you click here. Okay, once you click there, it appears there, then you create them. They are just saying new, and then you put description, and you say okay. So there, if somebody now comes back to employee here, let's say this employee here, you choose him. Then you want to give him allowances, you just come here and you add these allowances here. Like now, this one, once you've added there, you can be able, if it is a monthly basic, this is what, a basic plus house allowance, and then add monthly allowances, and then if you want to put monthly non-taxable allowances, you are able to put it there. If you want to put monthly taxable allowances, you are able to put it there. So once you've added them there, what happens is, if I put the name here, they will appear here. You simply just select. You simply select. You just say add. So when you say add, when I scroll, they will appear here. And then you select which allowance, and then you include amount. Then you say okay. Then that is where you input the allowances for each and every employee. Okay. So this is what happens, and then there are benefits. Also, this is where you indicate all the benefits that you would wish to extend to your senior employees. Your managers, directors, all those. So this is where you indicate all those employees, and then their holidays. So in holidays, there are recurrent holidays and then non-recurrent holidays. So recurrent holidays are those holidays that we know specifically are static. They cannot be changed worldwide. Like Christmas, we know it is 25th. So like now here, you can indicate those allowances, if services and vehicles, all of them. You can indicate their lower, their upper cases according to how the government has instructed. Okay, if it is cars and all that, you can define them here. Pickup, Land Rover, SEAT, whatever, all those, including trailers, even you can indicate them there. Okay, so all those things you can put them, and some of all of them are as per the government instructions. So these are the holidays. Yeah? This is where you can indicate the holidays. So if you know there are specific holidays like May 1st, we know that one is a recurrent holiday, okay? You indicate there, you just say May 1st. This is March, not May. Like this one, May 1st. You indicate there May 1st. And then you say, which holiday is that? You say it's Labor Day. Labor Day. So these are recurring holiday. Every May 1st, it's Labor Day. So it cannot change. Okay, then you say that. So once you say okay, it is already set in the system. So when it reaches May, this the system will treat this date as holiday. Okay, it will treat it as holiday. The other thing is December 25th. So you come here, you say December 25th. Okay, here you say it's what? It's Christmas. Okay, Christmas, and then you say okay. Okay, so once you say okay, that is a recurring holiday. Okay, so that is Christmas. And then the other thing, again, you come here, you say, which other holiday? All the recurring holidays. And then there are those distinct holidays. Okay, there are distinct holidays, they vary. Okay, these are holidays that maybe the government will feel like today we've gazetted. Mr. Matiang'i will gazette a holiday today, and you'll feel like Kenyans don't need to go to work. So those ones, which date? You come here and indicate. Like, for example, there was that holiday that Matiang'i, I don't remember, that Matiang'i actually announced and he gazetted it. So those are distinct holidays because they don't have specific dates in the year. So, but those recurring holidays, those ones you are able to preset them because you know worldwide that is the standard. So the ones in the country, you can come here, once the government has said something, you just come here and you indicate that holiday so that everybody, the system knows that this and this date, it was a holiday. So it will be able to treat that date as a holiday. And then we have internal training levy. this one's most trainings that I've undergone. So these ones you're supposed also to indicate that. And I'm sure most HRs will understand what ITL is, internal training in leave. This one is normally offered by the government, and there is also some percentage that the company pays for these trainings to the government. So unfortunately, most of the companies don't know about this, and they don't know that they need to actually make utilize of this leave training levies in their companies, because they always contribute to it and they don't utilize it. And then here you can put your employees' qualifications. Okay, you can put your certificates, degrees, diplomas, honors, KCSEs, all those kind of certificates that are available in your company, so that you know which guy to reward what when it comes to a certain proportionate of things that you may need. So that is about the miscellaneous. And then of course, lastly, we have reports. So we have 100 plus reports here. We have contract pay slips wherever. We have attendance analysis. And then in this attendance, we have the manual sheet attendance. Okay, and then for those who clock automatically via the biometrics, there is also that attendance for auto attendance. And then all these reports, and then we have all these like end of days. Mostly managers are given this type of right, the end of day right reports, for you to know every day what has actually happened, what has happened every day, okay, what has happened and all that stuff. So for example, if I want to see the HR loans that the HR has offered today, I'll just come here and click. Just click that, and then it will give me all the loans that have been offered today. Though today I've not given out any loans. So, and then you have this one, what you call staff accounts reports. So you come here and then you say staff balances or terminated staff and all that stuff. So you have all these transactions controls. Okay, then we have this transaction listing, staff withdrawal listing, deposit miscellaneous. Let's see how the staff withdrawal listing will look like. So this is how the staff withdrawal listing will look like, so that you may know which staff took what. And then we also have payroll history. So monthly payroll, pay monthly history accounting. So if you want to check, you can check. So this is the payroll from staff, basic housing allowances and all that stuff. Let me enlarge it here. If maybe you may not be seeing it properly, you can just enlarge it there. So you can see this is the listing of how it may look like. Okay, these are some of the things that are appearing in this report there. So that is how it is appearing. Okay, that is how the report will appear. And there are 100 plus reports that if you have time when you are going through this system and you have the rights, you are able to check all these reports that are being generated. And the reports are system generated. You don't need somebody to compile an Excel sheet for you. So it is system generated, but these reports, you are able to export them to Excel. So you are able to export each and every report on Excel sheet. Otherwise, thank you very much. And this is, lastly, we have a calculator, because we care, because we know sometimes you may need to do some calculations, and at times calculators are misplaced in your desks. So you only have a system generated calculator here that can help you do your work properly. Okay, mine is a little bit sluggish. Okay, it has opened. So you have a standard calculator there. If you need scientific, you can select scientific. Okay, this is a scientific calculator. Okay, and then if you need a graphics, these are graphing calculator, you just select them there. Okay, and then if you need a programmer's calculator like us, we normally like using this programmer's calculator. But most people I know, including accountants, HR, they use the standard calculator. So this is the calculator that you have. Otherwise, thank you very much for your time. Thank you very much for going through this video, and we appreciate. Please remember to subscribe, and also remember to visit us if you have more questions about this system, and if you really want to know also more about the implementations and in terms of cost, please make sure you reach out to me. My name is Aura, And my number is 0727-625-340. Okay, I repeat, 0727-625-340. Or you can visit us at Aspire Software Limited. That is, we are located in Lower Kabete Road, Spring Valley Business Park. We are there at Block A, first floor. So when you come there, Block A, first floor, just ask for Aura, and then you will be identified. I'll be there. That is where I am. You will find me there. Otherwise, thank you very much. See you again in other videos. And God bless you. Have a nice day.